is a very special day and it's a state holiday today. Usually we have celebrations at school, but due to the current situation, we're not going to school, and that is why I'm here at a very special place to remember one of the most phenomenal people who ever lived. Today I'm here at Sir M. Vishveshwarya's Samadhi. As you can see, there we have a bust statue, and I'm going to be sharing some facts about this renowned personality who contributed towards the growth and development of our country. So who was Sir M. Vishveshwaraya? Sir M. Vishveshwaraya was an Indian civil engineer who was more commonly known as Sir M.V. His full name was Sir Moksha Gundam Vishveshwaraya. He was born here in the Muddennahalli village, in that time Mysore state. He was born on 15th September 1860 and he was a very famous civil engineer who helped in the development of many roads, dams, and for the further development of many cities in South India as well as throughout our country and around the world. He was born here in the Muddennahalli village, which is situated in the foothills of the Nandi Hills. As we all know, Nandi Hills is a very famous place here in Bangalore, and this is located very close to it. So he was born into a Telugu Brahmin family, and he did his primary education in Bangalore. Then he received his BSc from the University of Madras, and then went on to receive his DCE, Diploma in Civil Engineering, from the University of Bombay under one of its affiliated institutions, the College of Engineering, Pune. After that, he did a lot to help in the development and growth of the beautiful civil structures in our country. He was the chief engineer in charge of the Krishna Raja Sagara Dam, situated in the suburbs in the northwestern part of the Mysore. That is a very famous dam located here, and it is most famous because it was engineered by Sir M.V. himself. He was also the chief engineer of Lakshmi Talav Dam near Kolhapur in the southwestern part of Maharashtra. He was also in charge of making a flood protective system for the city of Hyderabad. And this is what made him so famous. His contribution towards the engineering and building marvelous structures all around our country made him this famous, and he gained a celebrity status. He was also awarded the highest civilian award of India, the Bharat Ratna, in the year 1955. His birthday, 15 September, is celebrated as Engineers Day in India, Tanzania, and Sri Lanka. After all this, we can come to the conclusion that Sir M. Vishveshwaraya did a lot for us. Also, he had unconditional love for the language of Kannada and did many things to promote this language. He also started the Kannada Parishad and wanted things to be taught and explained in Kannada. Sir M. Vishveshwaraya was truly an engineering genius, and these people come only once in many years and are actually a blessing to the normal people. I'd like to share some more points about Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. So currently I'm in a museum which is dedicated to Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. This is very close to the Samadhi, around some 200 to 300 meters. Here you can see is the house where Sir M. Vishveshwaraya himself resided. It's a very beautiful looking house. And I really like these olden time structural houses. So coming to the points I would like to share with you. First, he was appointed as the 19th Diwan of Mysore, which is the second minister, and supervised the construction, building, and various other things of the state. At that time, Karnataka state was not formed, so it was called the Mysore state. Also, he was knighted as the Knight Commander by the British, by King George V, because of his contribution towards the betterment of the society. He also supervised the construction and building and gave some suggestions to build the Mukama Bridge over the Ganga River in Bihar. At that time, he was 90 years old and was considered as the father of modern engineering in Mysore. Also, he was the first person who developed and patented automatic floodgates which were used on the Khadakwasla reservoir in Pune. And after the success of the system, it was also put into the Tigra Dam in Gwalior, and this is what made him so famous. Inside the museum, you can see the awards like the Bharat Ratna he received, and it is so special to look at the highest civilian award of India so close. I have never seen the Bharat Ratna so close. And there are other awards which he received, his passport, his horoscope as well, and you can see some bits and bobs, the stamps. Then there are some diary entries which they mentioned over there, like he used to wake up at 7 a.m. and had his breakfast at 7 a.m. when he was 95 years old. And there were other entries like when he used to do his correspondence work, press meets. And when he was younger, his schedule was like full of studying every time. But then when he became the assistant engineer, that time he used to have lot of work. Like there are different kind of office work separated, like special office work, current office work, and only office work. So by the looks of the diary entry, it looks as though his schedule was jam-packed. There are also special clothes which was, you know, made as he was the Divan of Mysore for him. There are the trunks, baggages and luggages used by him. He used to travel abroad. As I told, he had his passport, and his cot is also present in a room with a life-size statue and some newspaper cuttings which tell us more about his personality, his family, and him meeting the Prime Minister of India at that time, and many other things, many souvenirs from the British period. So he lived in such an era that if you ever come and visit this museum, you'll get a glimpse of the just, you know, when India just got its independence and when India was under the rule of the British, because he lived from 1860 to 1962. He lived to be 101 years old. Can you imagine? That is like a century and a year. And he died in the year 1962 on 14th April. So that is it for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and share this video so that everyone gets more knowledge and informative about such things. And that is it for today. Hope you have a great day ahead. Don't forget to click on the bell icon to receive notifications whenever I post new videos. Bye-bye.